Testing, 1, 2, 3, is this thing on, ladies and gentlemen? Pow, pow, pow. Dr. Cyan Proctor, dun, 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 here in Cape Canaveral. What? Yes, you're here in town today for the SpaceX Crew 2 launch this morning.
Yeah, it was amazing. It was the most beautiful, spectacular liftoff I've ever seen.
It was. So it was completely dark out, completely the night sky.
And it lit up. It turned to daylight.
Right. It was fantastic. It was one of the best launches I ever saw. Cyan and I have worked together with so many different projects over the years. And then, as everybody knows, she got picked to be the first civilian mission pilot ever for a non-NASA mission, like coming up this September with SpaceX and the inspiration for the Shift 4 mission. And that is so that everybody in the whole world has been cheering for you this entire time. And now, finally, pow, pow, pow.
I'm going. Yeah.
Yeah.
It feels amazing. I'm so excited. So today's launch really made me think about, wow, I am next. And it's so exciting to have so many people cheering for me and supporting me and just wishing me well. And thank you. And Mike, you've always been an amazing supporter of mine. And we've worked on so many cool projects before.
Yeah.
And I love the project that you've got going right now called Human Airs.
Human Airs. Yeah.
Yes.
So you and I have talked about Human Airs forever. It's in my book, The Astronaut Instruction Manual. And then United Launch Alliance, who like is here with SpaceX, United Launch Alliance, and I partnered together on this project that reframes pandemic quarantine as space mission training for all the students, for students everywhere. And all that, they go to humanairs.org, and then they put their name, their grade, and it automatically generates a personalized letter of acknowledgement and certificate of accomplishment.
Yeah, and what I love about that is we've talked about analog astronaut and what it's like to live in Moon and Mars simulations, and now we have this year that has been so, you know, tough for a lot of students around the world to get through. But when we talk about Moon and Mars simulations, the whole idea is that this is very similar.
Yes, because being in a pandemic quarantine situation, there are so many different times in those experiences which resemble being in space mission training. And you know what? You mentioned analog astronaut. So over the years, you've been training as an analog astronaut, and so many different times, I saw people like, "What's an analog astronaut?" Totally confused that you would train on Earth to go to space,
right,
as if every astronaut ever didn't do that. They all do. They do it with, they go in the NEMO environment. Apollo astronauts did it. Mercury astronauts did it. The Mercury 13 did it. Everybody has done it. And you just took it to a professional level until you became pretty much the most famous analog astronaut in the world. And that made you so well trained for the upcoming Inspiration 4 mission.
I feel very lucky to have had all of these opportunities to live in Moon and Mars simulations. But it's been interesting this past year because I saw a lot of similarities for living in the high seas habitat for 4 months to being stuck at home and going outside. Every time we went outside, we had to, instead of putting on a space helmet in high seas, we had to put on the mask.
You and I have both been vaccinated.
Yes, we've both been vaccinated. And that gives us the opportunity. But to think about how challenging this has been, and from the student perspective, tell me, why did you start this?
So when I was working with students, I would be working in different places, and I would go to places and train with students in the same way that you would go to all the different places that you went to. But after pandemic, I would do that. After pandemic and during pandemic, and now we can't travel so freely. And so, let me clear my throat. When I was in my own space and couldn't go out, I immediately thought, holy smokes, this is like a space capsule.
Yeah.
I mean, because to go from Earth to Mars, it would take at least eight months to get there. So astronauts like yourself would be in a capsule and living on dried food and not going out, and you don't get to go outside and play kickball and everything like that. And that's when I realized that students today have already accomplished all those things. I approached Tori Bruno at United Launch Alliance. He saw it. He immediately got it. I love it. We worked on it for the past 6 months. And then on the one-year anniversary of a one-year mark, rather, of pandemic quarantine, we released and opened up the Human Airs initiative at humanairs.org. And then that's turned into what it has. And now it leads one space mission to another from right here in Cape Canaveral.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Doesn't that feel good to be here in Cape Canaveral?
It does.
All this heritage right here. We just were at the Cape Canaveral Public Library. Because because the public library, we're all about space and STEM, STEAM education, arts are super important. And the Cape Canaveral Public Library right here, we just shared with the librarians there who were telling us that they work to support kids in this community who want to grow up to be an astronaut.
Yeah.
Like yourself.
Which is fantastic. And it's such a good resource here right in the community.
And so that people can really train in our own homes and in our own communities like you did.
Yeah.
And led the way and showed us all how to do it. And that's what a human heir is. Someone who's training to be the next generation of space explorer from right here on planet Earth.
Let's do it.
Thanks for being... I love you so much. Keep up the good work.
Ooh, right there.
All right. Pow, pow, pow. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Mongo, Dr. Cyan Proctor. You are the next generation of space explorer from planet Earth. You are the next generation of space explorer from planet Earth. You are the
next
generation of space explorer from planet Earth. Pow, pow, pow.